Hello, dear viewer. Well, it's been a long time. Come here.
Yeah. You smell wonderful.
What? Oh, sorry. Well, I have to make a disclaimer before we start. When I was first recording this, a week ago, everything was fucked up. The sound was not working properly, the video format was all fucked up, so I just rage quit and never came back for 5 days. Now, I figured out how to clear all these problems and we're back. Second off, this is the most boring arc I've ever seen in this game. There's literally not much happening, so I'm editing a lot. If you want the full game experience, watch someone like Blade Lewitt or maybe Drakewing Gaming. They actually have the attention span to play a visual novel. So just go over there if you want to see the whole game. But now, without further ado, let's start with part 10. Boom. Incredible artist. I love him. Okay. You're probably asking, where has this motherfucker been? Not here. Not much else I can say. So, let's get back to it. As we sat together, listening to Miku play, day slowly turned into night. Leaning on Bjorn, what? Again? Through the window, I observed the last minutes of the evening sun painting the sky red and orange. Soon after, the clouds started to give way to a clear, silky smooth sky, slowly fading to black. So many things happened today already. The afternoon is over, but the memories of it will stay with me forever. Ah. Nice background, that's new. Days end so fast here up north during winter. I don't feel tired at all, quite the contrary, I'm full of energy, even though it's already dark outside. Above me, the stars look like small pebbles scattered across the night sky. Here, far away from the city and its polluting lights, they shine so much brighter. There's even the subtle band of light that forms the Milky Way slightly visible. It's a very cliché thing to think, but it's mind-blowing to think how big they actually are. So big and so distant. Impressive, isn't it? But who the fuck are you? What kind of professor? Huh? Well, I guess we'll find out. Okay, hi, welcome to the dark room. In case you're wondering, I actually looked through this whole arc of stargazing and it was incredibly boring. Nothing happened, we talked about stars, I don't give a fuck, I'm here for the furries. So, I guess I will show some kinda decent points that were kinda funny. Good evening, Professor. Shit.
Ha. Good evening, Lake.
Wait, Zweya, don't you have anything warmer than that sweater? I do, of course I do. Only it's back in my room. If you fucking remember, I'm homeless!
Look at the sky and try to locate the Ursa Major constellation.
Ooh, the Big Bear. Or Great Bear? That's easy. Bjorn is standing right here. Shut your dumb ass up, Lake. I like this guy already. It's a shame I don't have classes with him. Our physics professor is probably the grumpiest old man I've ever seen. He's really nice, but any joke about Uranus gets you thrown out of his class.
A comedic genius!
I will beat your ass for real. What the fuck are you talking about?
Even Miku is walking towards one alongside Bjorn.
Hey! What? Not my two boyfriends. We're skipping to the good part. Enjoy. Also, it's already the end of the day and I still haven't asked anyone about sharing the room for tonight. I think it's finally the time to make the decision and this might be the best moment for that. So, who am I going to ask? Woo! Choices.
Choices.
I make my choice. So you're all lined up today, but I only got one rose for one of you, bachelor style. Guess who I'm going to choose? Everybody knows who I'm going to choose. I'm going to choose Miku. Let's go!
Miko, I know that he would agree if I asked him. He wanted to take a room together with me from the beginning, after all. Why am I afraid of asking then? I look around, searching for him. Where is he? He's not far off from me, standing near one of the telescopes with Bjorn and Travis. I'm glad that Miko is making some new friends too. I know that opening up to others isn't that easy for him. Or maybe that's no longer the case? A lot can change during 3 years. I know I changed a lot too. We have some catching up to do for sure.
Oh, Sveja! Hey, what's up?
Sveja? Hello, good seeing you again. Hey, thanks. How's the assignment coming along? This is, by the way, the dream. These three people, oh, I would marry each and every one of you. Hey, thanks. How's the assignment coming along?
We're done, but only thanks to Travis. He's experienced with these sort of things, so we ask him for a little help, and instead he does almost everything himself.
I got my own telescope back at home. Using this one is no different. Did you finish already, Sveja?
I mean, I'm not finished quite yet, but you can help me finish. Oh, dirty joke, ooh. I didn't even start. I'm not sure how to use that sky map.
Oh, it's easy. It simply shows you the part of the sky you point your phone at. There's a menu on the right where you can choose specific planets and stars, and then the map guides you to them.
Travis takes out his phone and taps on the screen, launching the app and showing me step by step how to do this. It really does look easy. But I'm sure it's more fun doing this with the others. I'm glad I joined them now. Actually, I had hoped that Miko would try to team up with me and not Bjorn, but then again, it's not like I spent a lot of time with him today. Are you kidding me? I spent every single minute I could with him. Unless it was Bjorn who approached him about that while I went away. What is this unpleasant feeling in my throat? Am I jealous of him? Maybe a bit, but he's my longtime friend, so that's understandable. Wow, I had no idea I could be so possessive. I surprise myself every day, just not always positively. That seems easy enough.
Anyway, we already have the telescope in position, so you can take a look if you want. But if you want to try sending it yourself, then I don't want to ruin your fun.
If you have everything ready, then that's even better.
I'll go do the same on my telescope. You're free, have fun.
Oh, we will.
Sure thing.
Thank you, Travis.
See you later.
So go ahead, Sveja.
Oh, yeah, right.
Ooh, I can see, fuck. Oh my god, elementary school education, I don't know. What is this? Saturn?
I think it's Saturn. I lean in and look into the telescope. In the middle of the image, there's a rust-colored orb with a ring around it. I was expecting it to look like a flat image, but it's very real and three-dimensional. The planet casts a shadow on one side of the rings, and there's a thin shadow of the ring on the planet itself too.
It's not too big, but I see it very clearly.
Oh. Yeah, that definitely was something.
Something with a capital S.
I look up at the starry sky, dotted with twinkling stars. Saturn's now only a pale dot, tiny and distant. It looks nothing like the massive planet I saw just a moment ago. And it's just one pale dot among many. They're no longer just some shining dots in the familiar night sky. Now the stars and planets with their moons. An even distant galaxy, all of immense sizes and very real.
I love looking at the night sky. Actually, I think it's more fun without a telescope.
I like that too. Just sitting on the grass, looking at the vast space before you, feeling completely free. I enjoy looking for patterns in the stars. Not only the familiar constellations, but any shapes I can find. Instruments, dragons, bananas.
Bananas?
You have no idea how many bananas are up there in the stars.
What? Bananas again? Okay.
Once I even found a fancy cupboard.
It would be nice if it was summer already. We could lie down together on a hill beside the guest house, under the starry sky, and just do nothing in particular.
What else can we look at?
Ah, I see you like that. I'm not sure myself though. It's my first time using a telescope.
Maybe we could try checking the sky map. There was a list of interesting observable objects there. Maybe it could show us what's visible at the moment.
Oh, good idea. Let's try that.
Wait. I mean, Mikko, I have a question actually. Okay, let's go. Let's go. Let's psych up. You know, get on my fuckboy face.
You said if I needed a place to stay, I'm welcome in your room. Does that offer still stand?
Of course, you're always welcome.
Mikko smiled softly, a smile that could melt ice.
You know, you guys, I had a really tough week, and that's the first nice thing that happened to me. I'm gonna stay with Mikko in his room.
I never really paid that much attention to the height difference between us, but somehow now it strikes me that he has to tilt his head up to look me in the eyes.
Stop!
If I cuddle him now, I could easily rest my snout. If I cuddle him now, I could easily rest my snout atop of his head. So I do just that, stepping up to him and hugging him closely.
Everybody give it up for us. We did it, guys. It's a small step for humanity, but it's a big step for this fucking gay furry hat right here in front of his PC.
It's a pleasantly familiar feeling, feeling him snuggle back into me.
You two are cute.
Shut the fuck up, Bjorn. Get out. How about that?
You too.
Me? Yeah, sure. As cute as an ogre in a pink dress.
I think I could imagine an ogre looking cute in a pink dress.
Oh, come on now. I was joking. I hope I'm not that ugly.
Oh, I don't know.
What the fuck?
Bjorn looks at Mikko with sad eyes, dejected.
Hey, I'm kidding. You're a handsome guy. Really, you have nothing to worry about.
If you say so, I won't argue.
I will get back to you, Bjorn. Don't worry, I will get this handsome ass.
So while we're here, we were supposed to look for more planets to see, yeah?
For the next several minutes, we look through the telescope at whatever catches our interest. Bjorn marvels at everything with an unyielding enthusiasm I never suspected he had, while Mikko is mostly quiet but interested nevertheless. The end comes all too fast, just after we located Polaris and wanted to take a closer look at it.
Okay, it looks like our time here is up. Thank you all for attending the lesson. I hope you enjoyed it, and maybe even gained a new passion.
Supper is already waiting for you in the cafeteria. You're free to take it with you and eat anywhere you like. Have a good night, everyone.
I hope we get to use the telescopes again sometime. This was a lot of fun.
There wasn't anything about it in the schedule, but maybe.
It'd be nice. I enjoyed it too.
If you would be up to it, I'd like to come out sometimes just to watch the sky without any equipment.
Sure, that's a nice idea.
That could be fun too. You can count me in. But let's go to the cafeteria for now, though, before all the food is gone.
We are among the last ones to join a small crowd of students heading back to the guest house.
Okay,
let me geek out for a second. I really appreciate it. We have been in this room, but from another angle, and now we can see the other angle. The attention to detail is just... Oh. Ah, it's nice to be back in the warm inside. The jacket helped a lot, but I still prefer warmer temperatures. Some sauna would be nice now, but that will have to wait until tomorrow. The cafeteria is already crowded when we enter, filled with the buzzing voices of many animals of different species. Most of them are queuing up to grab their supper from the table near the entrance, but some are already sitting around the tables and eating. A lot of students take the plates and leave though. The queue is moving fast, so after just a short moment, we're able to gather our meal. Paper plates, each with two sandwiches and a slice of some cake, are lined up on the table in a few rows. Whoa. Small bottles of still water are standing on the other side of the table. I prefer sparkling water. Can I have some? Are we eating here or do you want to go somewhere else?
I thought about eating outside myself. Maybe even alone, if you don't mind that.
Oh, if you want to. But we could keep you company. That's no problem.
Don't mind me. I'll be fine. Besides, you two might want some time for yourselves.
Thank you. The first person in this goddamn game who gets it. Thank you for thinking, Bjorn.
Anyway, I grab my plate and I'm out. See you tomorrow.
See you. Have a good night.
Bjorn takes his food with him and waves us goodbye, leaving the cafeteria. How about you? Do you want to eat here? It's loud here. I thought about eating in your room if you don't have anything against this. Not in the slightest.
Yes!
Let us go to the room. We can eat first, and then we can eat each other, if you know what I mean. Wow, that was a really stupid joke. Sounded smarter in my head. We each take a plate and a bottle and leave the cafeteria. As we walk down the corridor, the bustling of the cafeteria grows weaker, giving way to silence. Even our steps are muffled by the thick carpet. The dim lighting gives the guest house an intimate feel. It's so quiet that I can hear Mika's breathing, soft and calm. All this feels very familiar, as if I've already been here together with Mika before, only forgot about it. You've been here 12 hours ago when we checked in. What the fuck are you talking about? It feels like the whole world is asleep. Let's not wake it up then. Okay, I will let that slide, Mika. Behind the glazed door to the common space, I see someone sitting in a chair. The person turns in my direction, but we walk past the door before I can make out who could that be. Mika opens the door and moves to the side to let me in.
Come in.
Ah, back in the studio. I still can't believe the amount of gear you packed for this trip. What? Ooh.
He's undressing. Are we undressing? Wait, let me get out of this clothes real quick. Wait.
I don't have a zipper. Let me get a zipper noise.
We're going to be here for a while, Sveya.
Yeah, but you took like half of your room with you.
Well, maybe 2/5. But I had some ideas I wanted to test, and I took only what I needed. If we were to hike to the guest house, I'd think twice before packing even half of that, but the bus took us almost to the entrance. Put your things wherever you want, by the way, and make yourself at home.
What things? I have nothing. Which bed is yours?
Oh, none yet. You can pick whichever.
No, wait. You pick a bed, and I'll pick the same one. I do as Mika said, hanging the borrowed coat on the hanger next to the entrance and putting away the camera bag on the table. Which, by the way, is already pretty cluttered, a bit too much to sit at it and eat comfortably. Where do you want to put all this stuff? I thought we could eat on one of the beds.
It's not like we need cutlery to eat a sandwich.
Well, right. We both sit down on the bed, the soft mattress bending under so that we lean on each other a bit. I finally take a better look at the food we were given. 2 rye bread sandwiches topped with slices of some dark cheese and sprinkled with pepper. Simple, but looks so good. Especially considering I'm already pretty hungry. The slice of apple cake is deliciously browned on the edges and smells faintly of cardamom and cinnamon. Looks pretty good.
Yeah, the food here is quite nice. Looks like I won't be forced to subject you to the horrors of meal replacement drinks.
Don't remind me. I grab the sandwich and bite into it.
What is this taste? This definitely isn't cheese.
What's wrong? I don't think that's cheese. What the fuck else is it?
Ah, yeah, I thought you knew. Have you ever seen cheese this dark?
Well, no. This is Brunost. Okay. A Norwegian specialty, not cheese. It's made a bit different than cheese, in a process that includes caramelizing sugars, giving it a sweet taste. Well, aren't you a fucking smart guy, huh? I've heard about it before, but I never actually tried it. It's really weird. I don't think I'm a fan, but maybe that's because I expected a taste of cheese, and that's something very different.
You can get used to it. But if you don't like it, then I can always make you some huahual.
What? Is it this bird? No, nothing's wrong with it. I'm eating.
Good then.
I finish the 2 sandwiches quickly, hoping that there are no more surprises waiting for me in that inconspicuous-looking piece of cake. Still, I inspect it suspiciously before taking a bite. The sweet and tart flavor of ripe apples fills my mouth. Oh, it really is good. The crust is perfectly baked and crumbles easily, and the hint of cinnamon enhances the flavor. It's really well balanced, with nothing overpowering the rich taste of apples. Oh wow, this is nice. Definitely makes up for the Brunost. A pleasured sigh escapes my lips before I bite into the cake again. I finish the last bite of the cake and lie back on the bed, a content rumble emanating from my chest. Waves of pleasure spread outwards through my body like a warm light glowing inside me. Mmm, that was good. Miku repeats my motions, lying back next to me and closing his eyes. Mm-hmm. We don't say anything for a while, just basking in the light of the foodgasm afterglow. Foodgasm? What the fuck is this, Tumblr 2013? I slowly start to doze off before Miku breaks the silence.
Svea?
Yeah? What are you thinking about?
Come on, Miku, take off your clothes.
Nothing. Why are you asking? I wasn't really thinking about anything. Maybe about the food and how nice it is to be here now. How about you? He says silent. Only after a while he says quietly, I missed you during those years of high school, you know?
Oh!
Okay, concentrate. His words are both sweet and heavy. Mom's spaghetti, weighing my heart down. What can I reply to that? Am I ready to talk about it? I just got him back. I don't want to lose him again. How can I tell him that I loved him? That being near him hurt so much I couldn't bear it. I can't. Not now. Not yet. Miku, it's good to have you back. Having him here next to me, I feel like things are as they should be. What a wonderful coincidence. What gods do I have to thank for this? Everything in its right place.
Everything in its right place.
You're still listening to them? Not really. They were always your band, not mine. Actually, I don't think I've heard them since the middle school. Just thought of this line for some reason. It's snowing again. Yeah? Mm-hmm. Just a bit. There's so much tension. Every single second I'm like, okay, what picture will pop up? Do you want to go out again? Of course. You know I do. But not for too long. I've had enough of this Arctic temperatures for one day. Miku extends his paw towards me. I grab it and let him help me stand up from the bed. His grip is firm, but his paw is tiny and soft and a bit damp. For Wolf, he has a very lithe build and delicate features. He was the same in middle school, and I was sure he'd still do a late growth spurt, but he didn't change much. Part of me is happy that he didn't. I grab my camera and we can go.
You're taking a camera? I doubt you'll be able to take any good photos at this hour.
Who knows? I'd rather have my gear with me in any case. Miku glances at all the musical equipment scattered across the room.
Yeah, I can understand that.
Where are we going?
How about we sit on the steps outside of the main entrance?
There's a roof over them, so if it's not too windy, they might still be dry. I'm already getting sleepy, so a shorter walk might be even better. I grab the camera bag and put on the coat, zipping it up to my neck. Ready?
When you are.
I hoped that this time I could see who it was sitting there in the common space, but when I peek into the room on our way, it's empty. Walking through the glazed corridor, however, we both see Bjorn still sitting outside on the edge of the terrace. Back in the cafeteria, he sounded as if he wanted to be alone. I think we shouldn't disturb him. He looks lonely. I don't think we should leave him like that.
Maybe solitude is what he needs right now.
We can just check on him and leave.
If you think it's right, we can go.
Okay, stop. We're ending it here. I'm tired. See you in the next episode. Good night.
Ooh.